Breaking tonight, a history-making showdown, 15 months in the making. Hillary Clinton versus Donald Trump in the highly anticipated first presidential debate. And it appeared nothing was off limits. Welcome to a live 11 p.m. edition of the Kelly File, everyone. I'm Megyn Kelly, reporting tonight.
Wow. That's what you saw at home if you were one of the more than 5 million viewers who tuned into this program on Monday night. What you did not see were the highly intense scenes that unfolded off camera to get us to that moment. We never show you that, right? You just want to see the end product, but sometimes it's fun to see more. For that, we allowed Showtime's The Circus to invade our offices, both at the debate site and back here at the studios in New York, and bring you a very rare look behind the scenes. Watch. Do you know anybody who's not watching this?
In terms of its significance, it's like it reminds me of a moon launch.
Yeah, right.
Let me talk about logistics tonight. We are getting reports that Mr. Trump may decide to leave the debate stage and head into the media spin room. This would be a first.
That'll be fun.
Effectively, we're going to go into the most watched broadcast in our history, having no idea what's going to happen.
So it's just a typical night on the Kelly File. Like a
plan. That's what makes our job so fun.
I've been at many of these things before, and there's nothing else like it. The tension when I asked Trump that first question at the first presidential debate Fox News hosted about the women. Trump thought he could dismiss it with a laugh about Rosie O'Donnell. And I didn't allow that. I kept pressing, and that's when he got mad. The stakes are so high in him, and I know he's been told by everybody to keep it together and not let her bait him. Yeah. But that could actually happen tonight.
Let's see how we're gonna go.
Here we go.
The other position for her is outside, and at that point in time, hang on one sec, I got another call coming in. Tom, make sure that Megan's aware what we're working on.
Ready?
Is the Pope Catholic?
7, 6, 5, 4. The storm is here, and you react to it as best. What we call rolling thunder. But hey, you know, that's TV.
Love that. Rolling Thunders, we throw out the rundown and we just bring you the news as it's happening. That's Tom Lowell, our executive producer, who is amazing and doesn't get enough credit. And Tommy Firth was there as well. In this next clip, you're going to see another woman on our team named Kristen Gubala when the hit the fan. As predicted, very little went according to plan. And while you didn't see it on TV, here's how that looked in our control room.
We ready? Come on in. Hot cameras. These cameras are live. How are you doing, sir?
Hey, we still have a minute and a half.
Obviously, with the debate going 12 minutes over, we don't have that kind of lag time we were hoping for, so it makes it a little more challenging, but we're used to it.
Stand by. We're about to be hot.
8, 7, 6, 5. It's all going to be for 3, 4, 3, 2, 1. Megan's my cure.
Breaking tonight, a history-making showdown, 15 months in the making.
Thank you. Stand by to change. Change.
The Brian Fallon lead is ready to go. You can go to Fallon whenever you want.
We do not have Fallon on set.
They're saying he's not there.
Get him in. Sit him down.
Our crew is saying he is not there. I don't know what you want me to do about that, but he is not there.
Hey, listen, they're trying to find Fallon.
They're bringing him down.
See Fallon right now?
I got 10 seconds.
Go.
Let's go. Yep. Bring him in now. Go, 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 go. Bring him in.
Joining me now, Brian Fallon, who's the National Press Secretary for the Clinton campaign. Did she execute the plan that you had for her? Because she was on the attack most of the night.
Well, I have to be honest. We were surprised by the Donald Trump that showed up tonight. This was somebody that, in the tail end of the debate, seemed to really go off the rails.
You guys are doing great. Thank you.
I need a status update on Kellyanne Conway. We need Trump representation here.
We're going to go to our soundbite, and then we're going to bring in Kellyanne. 4, 3, track Nexio, 2, 1. Kill the mics, change the guests now. Zoom on the air, 2, go.
I thought Mr. Trump at different times tonight showed great restraint, more restraint than I may have in the face of fire and lies.
He was taking heat for interrupting her.
She was doing, she was rolling her eyes, she was very glib, and sometimes she had a smirk on her.
And clear. Excellent job, everybody. Good work, good hustle.
Yeah.
I'll walk you out.
Okay.
General take on the day? What'd you think?
This was an exciting night.
It was.
I mean, it was just thrilling to see how they would do against one another. Yeah. And I think we learned a little bit about both of them.
Yeah. What do you think we learned?
She's not dying. I think we'll see a different Trump in the next debate. Joining me now, Mark McKinnon, co-creator and co-host of The Circus. That was fun, Mark.
There was more drama in the control room than there was in the debate stage. You guys really operate without a net, and thank you for letting us do that. Part of the ambition of The Circus is to show viewers and voters what it's like to be behind the scenes of a campaign. And I've seen that we showed from the campaign side, but we've never been able to show it from the news side. And that was fascinating for me because it's tense, and I know what it's like being tense on the debate side, being with a candidate, but I've never been in the control room of a TV room. Man, that's hot stuff.
You've seen more than I've seen because, you know, we're like Superman and Clark Kent. We're never in the same room at the same time, the control room team and me. But that's Scott Rosenthal, our director, who keeps, you know, the madness under control in there. And you can see the viewers never get to see the problems because we try to hide them from you. Oh, it's me and me. But that night, we didn't have Brian Fallon. He was supposed to be our lead guest. We didn't have Kellyanne Conway. She was supposed to be our second lead guest. Nobody was showing up. We were going on the air in front of
live TV, right?
5 million people. We had no guests at all. So you have to be able to roll with it. And one of the fun things about TV is you're getting an eyewitness view of what's happening in the control room where things are melting down. Like, where's Fallon? And I'm out on the set. All I ever hear is, Brian Fallon will be here in 2 minutes.
Be right there.
Right? Brian's
They're trying
next.
To keep you calm, right?
My only hint that something's wrong is in the background, you'll be like, get him! You're like, oh, whoa!
Well, they did a great job.
Any surprises, you know, when you saw the whole thing go down?
The whole thing was a surprise. I had no idea the control room was that chaotic and that dramatic. It was fascinating for me to see that, and I think it would be for viewers, too.
Yeah, I think so, too. And you'll get sort of a flavor for how we put the show together and the choices that we make and why we make them. And then there'll be some other shows featured, too, that you don't need to worry about. You can tune it away.
Well, the thing that we're doing the whole week, we have kind of a theme every week, and the theme this week is the newsrooms. And we wanted to show what it's like to see the campaign through the lens of news programs like yours.
Well, you guys were pros, all of you. So
thanks.
thank you for doing such a beautiful job.
You
it was a pleasure
it.
Having you. Kicked it. Marcos at the end of it goes, Megan, can I get a kick it? So I was like, kick it? Kick it? Only Mark could pull that off.